Ghosts are all around you. Ghosts come to you in your deep sleep. Some ghosts continue to live as they were still on Earth. You do not live alone in your home. There are invisible friends or foes sharing your residence. This is especially true with old places, where people, now dead, have lived before. We are ghosts too, but in human body. Like I mentioned earlier, a human ghost is exactly like you and me. The only difference is, they're invisible and untouchable. We move around, eat and sleep with our body. A ghost does exactly what we're doing, but without a physical body. They exist in what we know as an etheric body, astral body, or a soul. We too, have all that. We too are souls, just like a ghost. A ghost, like ourselves, also once tarried on Earth, worked, ate, sleep, exactly like us. But now those people are dead, and are known as ghosts. I hope you find viewing the clip as informative and meaningful. Don't forget to click like and you can subscribe so that you can be informed of further video clips from our Paranormal Life channel. Francis Keenan writes in Ghostly Encounters, True Stories of America's Inns and Hotels. On April Fool's Day, 1980, I bought an old mansion in St. Francisville, Louisiana, known as the Myrtles Plantation. Little did I know my first guest would be a ghost. I certainly did not really believe in ghosts and tried to convince myself my eyes had deceived me. But more and more ghosts appeared. Wondering if someone was trying to play a nasty trick on me, I went to the local sheriff with my problem. He and his men came and checked the house out. They saw ghosts too. Police Chief Larry Peters ran out of the house and vowed never to return. James Van Praa writes in, Ghosts Among Us, Unveiling the Truth. In a sense, we all are ghosts, that is, spirits residing in physical bodies. When our spiritual work is done on this earth, our physical bodies shut down and our ghostly body exits. The solid, dense energy of our physical body begins to deteriorate. The light, transparent energy body that is an exact replica of the physical body emerges and moves into the spirit worlds. There are no mistakes, and no deaths before their time. Nor are there deaths that could have been avoided. Why? Because there is no death, period. There is only a transition from a physical existence to a non-physical one. Once we are on the other side, we are officially termed ghosts. Dolores Cannony writes in, Between Life and Death. No matter how much we wish to push it to the back of our minds and not think about it, we know that the body is only mortal and will someday expire. What happens th? Ghosts share your house with you. Exploring further into the unknown, there are good ghosts and there are bad ghosts. There are human ghosts and there are demon ghosts. And there are other types of invisible beings all around us. Look at it this way, you consider you live alone or with your family or with your buddies all alone. But you ignore the fact, you share your domicile with ants, mice, creepy crawly insects, house flies, lice and fleas among innumerable life forms. Similarly, you also share your house with a ghost or ghosts and maybe with a demon or two. Who knows? I'm again saying, we're not a body with a spirit. We are a spirit inside a body. When you fall asleep, you become a ghost. Your physical body becomes lifeless and your soul ejects out of your body. Any outside the body encounters you will recollect as a dream. Most people have vague dreams. Most people forget their dreams. If a dream is important, you will clearly remember it upon waking up. Most times your deceased relatives, friends, and even spirit guides make contact with you in your sleep state. Actually, your physical body is your grave. It limits you within a mere three-dimensional perception. If you want to go from one place to another, you've to lift your feet up and down till you get there. But you as a ghost outside the body can fly. A ghost can be at any place anywhere in the universe and outside the universe instantaneously. Explaining further about my own soul projections, I've encountered several out-of-body experiences. Many times, I didn't know I was outside my body. I felt exactly the same outside my body as I would feel inside my body. I had the same cravings, hunger, thirst, sleepiness, instinctive act feelings, and so forth. Many times when I ejected out of my body, I could walk through walls, drink tea from a replica cup, float in mid-air and fall asleep outside my body. Repeating briefly, sometimes I'd become aware of my extended higher self known as my spirit self and at the same time being aware of my physical self. I would become aware I'm a trinity, I am three in one. I experienced I was looking at my body self and my body self looked at me, and I was both. It's exactly the same with my spirit self, I was all three of me in one. I thought my body was a limited lifeless doll. In fact, you must be more afraid of yourself than being afraid of a ghost. They don't know they're dead. There are so many stories being told and countless eyewitness accounts reported of house ghosts. But not many believe these stories. Neither did I, until I started encountering paranormal experiences. It was as real as you and I. My best buddy, Georgie, and I painted the town red on a Friday evening. We eventually decided to drive through the wide open road until we reached a remote town, Saldanha Bay, on the west coast of South Africa. We booked in at a motel and retired. Early the following morning, the moment just before waking up, I beheld an entire ghostly family inside the motel room. They appeared to be modern-day bushmen with high cheekbones. They were mother, father and children. I thought I was fully awake and I was puzzled. I thought we booked the empty room for just the two of us, Georgie and I, that is. Who are you? I inquired from the ghostly family who were all staring at me. The ghostly father responded, "We live here. But you and your friend are welcome." My eyelids flickered open. I looked around me. No one, except George, who was asleep, blanket pulled over his head. I remember sleeping at another buddy, Clarence, in his apartment for 2 weeks. That was in Windhoek, capital of Namibia, 1800 km from Cape Town. His 4-year-old daughter Stacy Lee was second sighted. The child would scream all the time, pointing her finger that there was an elderly lady in the house. Alastair Wickham writes in his book, The Dead Roam the Earth: True Stories of the Paranormal from Around the World. It was on January 16, 2004 that a young police officer was patrolling alone in his car in the early hours of the morning, 3.15 a.m. to be exact, in Colonia Valles de la Silla, a small town in Mexico. Leonardo Samaniego had had a quiet night so far, it was cold and people were only too glad to be indoors, so when he turned into Alamo Street, he expected it to be deserted. Instead, he was just in time to see something enormous fall from the bare branches of a tree. It dropped rapidly, but made no impact on the ground, seeming to hover just above it. Samaniego put his lights on full beam and saw what he took to be a woman in a black cloak, with dark brown skin and round, black, lidless eyes, floating a few feet above ground. She looked straight into the headlights for a second before flinching violently. Then she landed on the ground, writhing and struggling to cover her eyes, apparently in agony from the brightness. The officer had a clear instant of recognizing what seemed to be impossible, the word bruja, the Mexican term for witch, flashed into his mind, and then the creature was flying through the air, incredibly fast, and had fastened on his car. Samaniego saw dark brown arms and large hands with claws scrabbling against the windscreen, the black eyes, much larger close up, seemed to fill half the glass. Powered by terror, he jolted the car into reverse and accelerated backwards, shouting into his radio for backup. He managed to guide the car all the way up the street, with the creature clawing at the glass, and then he passed out. A few minutes later, another patrol car reached him, followed by an ambulance. They found him unconscious but unharmed and quite alone. In a state of shock, Samaniego gave his story to his fellow officers. He also gave it to doctors at the hospital where he was taken for examination, and, incidentally, tested for drugs, alcohol, and mental instability, on all of which he came up clean. The precision of his story struck many people, and an interview with him was broadcast on TV news. During the next few days, hundreds of reports of similar sightings came in. In other words, the author narrates the being the police officer encountered was real. There are many such stories going around, few would believe it, until it happens to them. Ghosts relive their earthly experiences. Ghost Girl Hitchhiker. A motorbiker told a local Cape Town newspaper how he had picked up a teen girl hitchhiker who wanted to go home. He said she wore a very short dress and adorned heavy makeup on her face. The hitchhiker showed concern because it was early evening and that the hitchhiker was still a child of about 16. He told her to hop on the back of his motorbike. He went to her home address and knocked on the door. An elderly couple opened the door. The motorbiker remarked, "You can't be her parents, you're too old." When he turned around, the young girl had disappeared. The elderly couple invited him inside their house and took him to the lounge area. They offered him a cup of tea. The elderly couple showed him a photograph of their daughter, to which he responded that it was the young girl he had given a ride on his bike. They explained they were her parents and that she was killed 40 years before. They said she ran away to go to a dance club and was hit by a car and died. I should say, from the ghost girl's perspective, after 40 years, she was hit by the car a moment ago. She found herself trapped inside a timeless void, that everything is occurring simultaneously. The past, present and future occur at once. She is beyond time and space. She is completely unaware.